All right, now let's talk about the race for City Hall tonight. We're just 11 days from the primary, and today, another major poll with good news for Bill de Blasio. I still can't figure this thing out here. You've got here, as you look at the numbers here, de Blasio at 32%, Thompson 18%, and Christine Quinn, who had, with all the troubles, was always the presumptive front runner, sitting at 17%, and you got the rest. Somehow Anthony Weiner still gets 11 points. But anyway, that all said, Dominic, when you look at those numbers, and then you look at it, if there were a runoff here, or at least just putting the three head-to-head, de Blasio, under every metric, does well. And even in the sampling, and you know polls better than me, they did take cell phone numbers into account. So the underrepresentation of the black vote, which we always say isn't factored in, even if you say it's not counted all the way, he's winning going away here with these numbers. I still can't figure it out. I argue his name recognition for the casual person isn't nearly as good as Thompson's and Quinn, but obviously I'm wrong.
Well, it's real simple. The city wants to go in a different direction. Primary voters are to the far left. Bill de Blasio has out African American, the African American in the race. There's no other way to say it. The African American wife who admitted to lesbian experiences, all of it is working for Bill de Blasio. And if you better watch this guy, because if you don't, he might get the 40% and avoid a runoff. The name of the game, if you're Bill Thompson, is to stop his momentum. And Christine Quinn is in serious trouble tonight.
Today, 11 days out, Dominic, if you did a poll, got the pulse here of the Quinn folks and the Thompson folks, who's more nervous they won't make the runoff?
Christine Quinn.
Wow.
Bill Thompson's going to, he's underrepresented with the black vote. He's going to do better than what polling's showing now. Christine Quinn is at her max. If things don't turn around, she's not even going to make the runoff. It reminds me of Alan Hevesy when we were told he was the next mayor, yep, and it didn't work out for him.
Almost as shocking to me, controller's race, which nobody was really focusing on, but we all took as a foregone conclusion that Elliot Spitzer was the guy. All of a sudden, Stringer, and I think his ad, by the way, is really good, right? But anyway, Stringer is neck and neck.
Well, we got two contrasting. That's from Quinnipiac. That came out yesterday, and that shows them exactly tied, and that would be a 19-point swing in 2 weeks. But show the Times, if we can, which came out today. They still have it as a 15-point lead for Spitzer. So there may be some variation in the polls here, but I got to wonder if maybe Elliot Spitzer is suffering from a little bit of Weiner scandal phobia. That, you know, when Weiner cratered, I think a lot of people were like, enough of this. We don't need any more of this scandal. And some of that started to bleed onto Elliot Spitzer, I got to think.
And I also think that commercial spot where people are given an excuse to vote for, let's say, a Stringer when they see the Times endorsed and they see all the endorsements, he looked like a real candidate, a lot more serious than maybe the Stringer that we know, mm-hmm, right? It was always, you know, like almost a caricature at times. Mm-hmm. I don't know what would be a bigger shocker, de Blasio coming out of this thing here, or Stringer, but either way, it's not how we saw this thing playing out about a month ago. All right, talk of the table. When we come back here, a couple good questions, and they both relate to who's driving and what they're doing. Stay with us. We'll be right back.